Welcome back to the 17 News at Noon podcast, where we share your news on your schedule.
Working in the spirit of the Golden Empire, this is 17 News at Noon.
Good afternoon, and thanks for joining us for 17 News at Noon. I'm Nicole Gitzke. And we begin with another surge in cases. Public health officials announced more than 1,000 new cases in Kern County. We also learned another 6 people have died. Most of the cases reported are from people who tested positive after Thanksgiving. Since the holiday, nearly 4,800 people have been infected. Over 47,000 Kern County residents have tested positive since the pandemic began. Our death toll now stands at 463 people who have lost their life. And Rosedale Union School District announced yesterday they are sending students home for distance learning. And the memo sent out to parents and students, the district said the change was made due to the shortage of substitute teachers. The district will discuss a return to in-person learning during a board meeting next week. School officials said they hope to return to in-person learning on January 4th. And testing is still an important way to help get the coronavirus under control. Kern Public Health has an all-in-one place where you can find your nearest testing site. You can find it at an interactive map on the Kern Public Health website. It shows you where you can find paid COVID-19 tests, free tests, including sites that offer a $25 gift card. You can also click on each testing location to find more information on appointments, testing dates and times, addresses, and contact information. Just go to kernpublichealth.com and click on the COVID-19 section. Public Health says they have handed out over 5,200 gift cards so far. Officials say nearly 400 people were tested at yesterday's Oildale location. Back in October, only 45 people got tested at that same location. Now to your 17 Crime Watch. A standoff in Oildale lasted for more than 6 hours yesterday before coming to an end. Woodland Meadow Court, north of Merle Haggard Drive. The sheriff's office says Stephen Gunaway took a hostage around 1 o'clock yesterday afternoon. The hostage was eventually let go, but Gunaway stayed inside for hours. Just around 6 o'clock, Gunaway came out with his hands in the air and surrendered without incident. He is due in court tomorrow. And we have new information on a shooting that kills one earlier this month. The shooter now in custody. According to Kern County Sheriff's Office, back on December 1st, a number of officers responded to the area of Flower and Miller Streets for reports of a shooting. Officials say they found 39-year-old Eduardo Javier Cardenas, who had been shot several times. He was taken to the hospital where he later died. KCSO says they've arrested Michael Stephen Green late last night in connection to the shooting. Now, if you have any information, call KCSO at 861-3110. And a man reported missing after a party in Lake Isabella is dead after crashing in the Kern River Canyon. The man's vehicle was recovered yesterday just off State Route 178. According to CHP, the man is from Bakersfield and was reported missing Tuesday morning when he did not return home after the party on Sunday. A search team flew over the canyon and spotted his vehicle. His body was found inside along with his dog. CHP confirmed that the man was 44 years old and was not wearing his seatbelt. Officers are still working to determine whether drugs and alcohol were involved in that crash. Now, despite alleged threats of retaliation, Monsignor Craig Harrison is refusing to drop a lawsuit after the diocese against the Diocese of Fresno. And that's according to his attorney, Kyle Humphrey, who held a news conference about an hour ago. The pastor of Bakersfield at Francis of Assisi Church was part of multiple allegations after allegations of sexual misconduct surfaced back in April of 2019, but authorities never filed criminal charges. Now, 17's Bob Price will have more tonight on this on 17 News. Well, today is the day that KGET TV 17 joins forces with the Children's Miracle Network for a day of giving to benefit the Lawrence Small Children's Center at Bakersfield Memorial Hospital. It's a day when we reach out to you, our loyal viewers, to contribute to the mission of advancing medical care for kids in Kern County. Now, 17's Tammy Melchok and Jim Scott are hosting our day-long fundraiser again this year and join us from our studio. Guys, how is it going today so far?
Hi, right. Nicole. Going pretty well.
We're into
hour number 7 now in our 14-hour-long fundraiser to enhance medical care for kids here in Kern County. I just got to get to some business right here, Tammy.
Let's hear it.
I got to thank Stuart Grindy from Long Beach. He made a $50 pledge to CMN here in Kern County. Code Precast Products out of Shafter. gave us a check for $1,000 this morning.
Nice.
Our esteemed mayor of Bakersfield, Karen Goh, with a $100 pledge to CMN today. Danny Russell with a $100 pledge. Kate Yusey with a $150 pledge. Greg Lopez, now you remember the president and CEO of Memorial Hospital, Ken Keller, made a $250 pledge, and he challenged other hospital presidents.
That's right. Yeah, this morning on Sunrise.
To match that, and Greg Lopez has matched him with a $250 donation. $250, $50, $5. It all matters to us. And remember, being a miracle maker is perhaps the best way to stretch your dollars. That's $20 a month for 12 months. And for your pledge in becoming a miracle maker, a bear from Walgreens. These bears will be given to a sick child at Memorial Hospital. Plus, a portion of that pledge will go to purchasing a sleep sack for a newborn at Memorial Hospital at Lawrence Small Children's Center. Sleep sacks are proven to be kind of a first line of defense against sudden infant death syndrome. So many ways to give, but the most important part is picking up that phone right now and making your pledge.
Yes, that's right. Our friends from the Hispanic Chamber of Commerce are with us on the phone bank right now, a scaled down phone bank due to COVID-19 considerations. But it's always good to have our loyal friends from the chamber on board.
Absolutely.
Yes. And upstairs, our radio partners are reaching out to their listeners to call in those pledges to CMN. E.J. Tyler with KGFM Radio 101.5 FM with us again. And say hola to our Spanish radio partners with La Caliente, KEVT 96.9 FM, and El Escobal and La China. Very grateful again to our radio partners for their support of Children's Miracle Network.
They are a huge part of the team here, and they do believe in this mission.
They sure do. And, you know, having a preemie can be very stressful, but imagine having three at the same time.
Ew.
Well, Jason and Kayla Nation of Bakersfield were thrilled when they were finally able to bring their triplets home. But it wasn't long before the babies came down with a life-threatening illness. Here's their story.
Madison was 3-4. Brooklyn weighed 3-1. And Brayden was 4-5.
Born at just 32 weeks, Madison, Brooklyn, and Brayden Nation spent 1 month in the NICU at Mercy Southwest Hospital before they were allowed to go home. But the homecoming was short-lived. Just 2 weeks later, they were admitted to Memorial Hospital.
We took Madison first, and Madison and Kayla ended up staying with Madison. Well, then I ended up having to take Brayden and Brooklyn the next night. They were in a hurry to get Brayden hooked up to quite a few machines.
Because his oxygen was so low when he got there that they didn't even take him out of his car seat to hook him up.
The triplets were diagnosed with RSV, a potentially life-threatening respiratory infection.
One of your friends their kid had just had RSV, and he had shown me a picture on Facebook and came close to like dying from it. And so then when ours got it, it really kind of terrified me because, you know, your mind goes to the worst place.
Madison, Brooklyn, and Brayden spent 2 weeks at Memorial Hospital, where they were cared for around the clock, hooked up to equipment purchased through Children's Miracle Network, and with donations made by you, our generous viewers.
I think you see those things on TV and you don't really think like, oh, that could be you. And then when it is you, it puts like a whole different perspective in your mind of how you look at those mediathons and what they're really going towards.
Thank you.
My goodness.
They're so adorable. And the Nation triplets turn 4 years old next week, so an early happy birthday. All right, welcome back. Now, we are seeing some cool conditions out there today, but let's send things over to Kevin Charette so he can give us a look at our forecast.
Well, Nicole, it's a great start to the afternoon. We've got some high clouds out there. As we take a look outside, some wispy clouds in the distance off to the east and a current temperature of 59. Today, we're looking at mid-60s in Sacramento, 67 in Fresno. We'll look for 70s in Morro Bay, Los Angeles, and San Diego. So comfortable temperatures all around. Partly cloudy for you today, a light wind, 67 in Bakersfield, 66 in Delano, 68 in Taft. And then for the mountains, no advisories in place. A northwest wind 5 to 10 today, 41 in Fraser Park. 63 in Tehachapi with 60s to lower 70s into the Kern River Valley. And then for the desert, you're looking partly cloudy and northwest wind 10 to 20 and 66 in Mojave. Here's your extended forecast. Tomorrow, we'll cool things down a little bit. 62, 50s in place Friday and Saturday. And then for the weekend, upper 50s, lower 60s with a little bit of cloud cover around the area. For the mountains, I do expect to be a little bit breezy for Thursday. We'll keep you in the 60s still. And then we're in the 50s for Friday into the weekend and some clouds rolling on in as well. Overnight in the 20s and 30s. And then for the Kern River Valley, a pretty nice forecast. 50s and 60s in place Thursday through Tuesday. If you're going to be making weekend plans, we are expecting to see a little bit of cloud cover around the area and temperatures overnight still into those 30s for the most part. But today, not a bad day to get out and enjoy this nice weather with a few high clouds and above average temperatures. We've also been talking about CMN. I hope you will make that donation today. And I know Jim and Tammy are going to have a lot more on that coming up in just a bit. Back over to you.
Welcome back. These are tough times, but a local company is hoping to help struggling businesses. Now, every year, Sullivan Petroleum Company and Soli's Convenience Store gives personalized gifts to 70 or so vendors and customers. But given the circumstances this year, the company instead is going a different route, investing that money back into our community like Luigi's. Now, the company announced it has allocated $14,000 to purchase roughly 70 gift cards to local restaurants. These gift cards will then be sent to Soli vendors. Well, he has impressed Bakersfield and the world, and last night, voice contestant and local pastor Jim Ranger got one step closer. Bakersfield's very own Jim Ranger is moving on to next week's finale on NBC's The Voice. Ranger was among five contestants who will compete to win it all next week. Monday night, Ranger performed Without You during the live semifinals. He dedicated that song to his dad, also a Bakersfield pastor. His father says he usually gets to see the rehearsal, but yesterday was a different case. Now you can catch the finals on Monday night. That will air right here on NBC 17 at 8 o'clock.
Working in the spirit of the Golden Empire, this is 17 News at Noon.
The 17 News at Noon podcast is a production of KGET and Nexstar Media Group. For more on all of the headlines in today's show, head to KGET.com.